You merely adopted the dark. I was born in it.
Before Tom Hardy would star in the iconic film franchises including Star Trek, Batman, and Mad Max. Before Tom Hardy would become one of the most sought after actors in Hollywood and would have a legion of both male and female fans.
Are you asking me about my sexuality?
Sure.
Why?
Why?
Thank you.
Okay.
Before Tom Hardy would bring his dog obsession to the red carpets of Hollywood. Before Tom Hardy left Leonardo DiCaprio for dead in The Revenant and got an Oscar nomination for his portrayal of John Fitzgerlad.
The proper thing to do would be to finish him off quick.
He's to be cared for as long as necessary.
I understand.
Now Tom Hardy, he was nearly dead himself after struggling with a substance abuse problem through his late teens and early 20s. The guy would black out on the regular, sometimes he'd wake up on the other side of London, sometimes he'd wake up in another country. But regardless, he always managed to get to work because he loved being an actor. Tom just seemed to find trouble from the get-go, getting expelled from elementary school for stealing, then arrested at 15 for joyriding while in possession of a gun. Now his good looks, they would land him a modeling contract when he was only 19, and he started to take classes at the prestigious Drama Center out in London. There he would put in 60-hour weeks perfecting his craft, but he was often overshadowed by another student by the name of Michael Fassbender. After securing his first feature film in Black Hawk Down and an HBO series known as Band of Brothers, appearing in that one alongside Michael Fassbender, yeah, he couldn't shake that guy. He would then go on to reflect on his craft and get some tips from his dogs. Not even kidding. What's going on, guys? My name is Michael McCredden, and welcome to Before They're Famous, documenting the life and career of Tom Hardy prior to fame, here for you on Before They're Famous. Now, you guys requested this video. Be sure to let me know in the comments down below who you want to hear about next. And Leonardo DiCaprio, I've already done it.
Did you talk to him about Titanic?
There was definitely space on the door for both of them, and she didn't move over.
Did you talk to him at all about that?
No.
Tom Hardy was born Edward Thomas Hardy on September 15th, 1977 in London, England. He was the only child of mother Elizabeth Ann, an artist and painter, and father Edward Hardy, a writer of English and Irish descent. Now Tom Hardy, he hails from East Sheen, London, but his family, they would often take trips to the south of France, and at a young age, he learned how to speak French. He was determined to get away from his dull life in East Sheen, and he attended Richmond Drama School through his teens. It wasn't long before he joined the Drama Center in London in September of 1998, where he would take note of one classmate who was 2 years ahead of him. According to Tom Hardy, well, at the time, Michael Fassbender, he was the guy everyone wanted to be like. It certainly wasn't Tom.
Oh, shit.
Sir. Where's my stop?
Now, it didn't take long for Tom to get expelled from this school because, well, he was a little bit of a shithead. He was getting into all sorts of trouble. But his career, it would move forward, and he also found love marrying his first wife, Sasha Ward. Now his acting chops, they were undeniable, and he booked a role on the epic war film Black Hawk Down. He soon won the role of lead villain in the Star Trek Nemesis film.
Not for long, Captain. I'm afraid you won't survive to witness the victory of the Echo over the Voice.
Now with Tom Hardy finding success in 2003, he also began battling an addiction to crack. In 2003, he collapsed at the Soho Old Compton, and that's when he decided he had to get his life together. He checked into rehab. Also, that marriage, well, it ended because, he was up to no good. Now, if you're wondering what Tom looked like back at this time, one needs to pay a visit to his old MySpace account, where he would often post candid snaps in an effort to attract a few single ladies. When speaking of these photos now, he states that he is not ashamed or embarrassed at all. In fact, they captured, in essence, him in his natural habitat. Sobriety suited Tom, and after a successful recovery, Hardy would begin working consistently in film, television, and theater over the next 5 years. And this is where his admiration for dogs, well, it would come in handy and help him work on his acting chops, no joke.
Stand by. Yeah, he's a proper member of the club. Fully paid up member.
He started rehearsing in front of his canine companions, saying, "It's very soul-destroying. They're very harsh critics, dogs, and they're very rarely impressed." He also began studying their mannerisms. He says they're very honest with their eyes, with their body, and it's very hard to fool them. And, if anyone, follows me on Instagram, you know I'm obsessed with my dog, so this might be something I'm gonna try out. But it seems kind of weird. Buster, are you not impressed? He wouldn't be impressed.
can I get a biscuit?
Now, Tom's unorthodox methods would prove him successful with his powerful performance in the 2008 film Bronson.
All my life, I've wanted to be famous.
His work as Charles Bronson, the most violent prisoner in all of Britain, well, it began to turn some heads in Hollywood. It also began getting him a whole lot of attention from the ladies and the fellas, because in that film, he appears naked multiple times. Bald, bulked up, and sporting Bronson's signature strongman mustache, Hardy was unrecognizable and proved he had the chops to be a leading man. His efforts would win him a British Independent Film Award for Best Actor, followed by being named one of Variety's 10 Actors to Watch. He also caught the attention of Christopher Nolan, who was working on a project where he needed a guy to, you know, bulk up and have a physical presence. And,
then he would go on to become big.
Victory has defeated you.
And the rest of the story, well, you know the story because this is Before They're Famous. My name is Mike McCrudden. Thanks for checking out my personal channel. I do all sorts of celebrity bios on here. Be sure to let me know in the comments down below who you want to hear about next. Also, I'm filming this prior to the Oscars of 2016. I really think he deserves one. I hope he wins, and Leo as well. Anyway, guys, I'll see you in another video.
Yes, I was wondering what would break first, your spirit or your money.